Hello. I'm not making a video about repairing this HP because was very hard to repair. He take some water. It's HP ProBook 640 G1. Okay. After making repairing it, it has some condenser beneath chipset and some resistor eaten by oxides from water because people after spill water on laptop. They don't come quickly to clean it. So, after repairing it, I'm not putting this board with LEDs and security card reader. Also, I'm not putting wireless and not this one connector. You know, when repairing it, you power, verify to power on with minimal accessories because take time to put it all these expansional devices every time. So, I'm not put it also this module. It's module with two USB and network card. Because I have two USB here, which I use it to BIOS recovery. So, all my problem was because I'm not putting this expansion card. Okay, now we power on. Sorry for quickly messing around the video. So after putting that, laptop coming on. But focus, please. But with not with video signal and funny spinning allowed. Exactly how is happening when don't have BIOS with ClearMe or when CPU is bad. Or when CPU is changed, okay. So now coming on, okay. Spinning very fast, video no. And take out this one. Take out the charger. Put it back. That piece of shit. Sorry about that. And now I have to keep the laptop because power goes hard. Okay, we entering hard in the socket. So we have video. HP minds. So not putting this one. No video and fan spinning very loud. Okay, now we have video. We power down. Okay, we powering up again, and we have video. You know, crazy, crazy HP. After repairing it in like 3 hours, I spent it another 2 or 3 hours to refresh the BIOS. Now it has original BIOS. Dismantle an Fujitsu and take its CPU, because I guessing the CPU it was the fault. No. Is that piece of, you know. Okay, that's it. So always you need this.